饭店，各位啊、那个与会的大德，大家早安。
好，
我们就正式开始研讨会第二天的第一场。啊，今天的第一场上午呢，有两个啊、发表。我们的时间哈、是8:30到10:00。总共有90分钟，对，一位发表者有45分。那我们这里建议呢，就是发表者大约啊、发表35分钟，包括翻译。那我们留10分钟作为讨论。当然就是，当这个翻译如果稍微啊、要时间的话就可以，那10分钟可以稍微缩短。好，那啊、今天两位的发表者都是啊、尊者。第一位呢是净法长老，净法长老的净法长老是马来西亚槟城法悦林的住持啊、他所发表的题目呢，是要介绍塔尔禅师啊、的英文的书、啊。第二位是智行长老，那、智行长老本身呢，目前、在台湾的净乐禅林是佛法的导师，他呢像以前古代的这个印度的法师一样，要到中国东亚传法，所以他快要变成台湾的法师，很期待他那个我们会学到非常非常多东西。好，那智行长老的这个讲题呢，也是在谈塔尔禅师的著作，特别是最重要最大部的著作是《趋向涅槃之道》啊，有一个很有趣的话课题是 这本著作的出版为何会在台湾发行而不是在缅甸发行，那精彩可期。 OK， 那我现在用英文很简单的介绍啊、Venerable monks and others participants, good morning. This is the first session for tomorrow's morning.We will have two presentations about, I think about 45 minutes for each session. And I suggest that the presentation could be taken as 35 minutes, including the Chinese translation. So, and leave 10 minutes for discussions or flexible for the Chinese translation. And the first presentationwill be presented by Bande Dhammasupo. Bande Dhammasupo is the abbot of Nandaka Vihara in Penang, in Malaysia. And his topic is Introduction to Venerable Siyado's Books in English. And the second presentation will be presented by Bande U Nyanajara. Bande Nyanajara is currently the teacher of teaching Buddhism at the Jingle Chanting. So his topic is Why Pao Xiaodo's Masterpiece, the most important and very thick one, Nibbana Gaminibhadibhada, was published in Taiwan in 1998 rather than in Burmese. So this is a very interesting issue.Okay, now let us welcome the first presenter, Bande U Dhammasupo. 以热烈掌声来欢迎第一位进来。
其实、
短
的中文是在楼下三楼 Chinese language 里帮我学的，可是最后呢是那个中那个基础和中级的中间，所以我还是 present 在用英文来 present。 our teacher, the Venerable Pao Xiaolo, has written a few books in English. So here I would like to take this opportunity to talk about some of those books. First of all, I would like to list out those books which are, number one, The Only Way for the Realization of Nibbana. Number two, Knowing and Seeing. Number three, Mindfulness of Breathing, Anapanasati. Number four, Towards Eternal Peace. Number five, Light of Wisdom. Number six, The Workings of Karma. Number seven, Mindfulness of Breathing and Four Elements Meditation. I have listed these books at random and so on, so they are not listed by way of chronology or importance. I will now give a brief summary of those books, except Mindfulness of Breathing and Four Elements Meditation, because this book has been incorporated into Knowing and Seeing, the second book.
Our 导师尊敬的包尔禅师写了几本书，在英语出版了几本书。那在此呢，我要以这个把握这个机会，借这个机会去讲解那导师所出版的一些书。首先呢，我会列下这些书，那就是第一，证悟涅槃的唯一道路；第二，如实自见；第三，安波念或者入处习念；第四，朝往永恒的极境；第五，智慧之光；第六，业的运作；第七，安波念即世界分别观。那我是很笼统的把这些书这样子列下来，而不是根据它的出版年代或者是它的重要性。那接着呢，我将会对这些书呢给一些浓缩的表达。
This book, The Only Way for the Realization of Nibbana. The Only Way for the Realization of Nibbana is published in 2011 in A4 size paper. It has about 85 pages. The title of this book comes from the introductory or beginning passage to Mahasatipatthana Sutta. Therefore, this book is about the attainment of Nibbana through the practice of Anapanasati as taught in the in and out breath section of Mahasatipatthana Sutta.
证悟涅槃的唯一的道路是在2011年出版的，在以这个 A4 的这个纸张出版，总共有85面。那这本书的名字呢，是取自于这个《大念处经》的那个开题的那个部分。那也就是，所以呢，这本书呢是讲解这个涅槃之道，证悟涅槃之道。那么是根据这个《大念处经》里面所从那边所讲解的那个安波念开始，第一本安波念开始。
The preface to this book. Before going into the explanation of the sutta, Venerable Xiaolo gave us a preface or introduction to show us some preliminary information we should know before trying to understand the way of practice as taught the Mahasatipatthana Sutta. Firstly, Venerable Xiaolo discussed the four tasks which needs to be done to attain Nibbana. These four tasks are related to the Four Noble Truths. He then explained the development of meditation, that is the development of Samatha Vipassana as taught in the suttas. In Mahasatipatthana Sutta, the Buddha described Samatha's development in practice under 12 subjects of Bodhi contemplation, which are contemplation on the in and out breath, Anapana, contemplation on the repulsiveness of the 32 parts of the body, contemplating on the four elements, and contemplating on the 9 types of crops, total 12. Furthermore, this jhana are explained as the basis for practicing vipassana, mentioned that jhana concentration produce exceedingly bright light, which is the light of wisdom, where a meditator can use that light to discern ultimate materiality, paramattha rupa, ultimate mentality, and their causes. These are the objects of vipassana meditation. It is pointed out that although these objects of vipassana may be called five aggregates in some sutta, or six bases in some other suttas, or the four foundations of mindfulness, we should understand that they are nothing more than just materiality and mentality. Therefore, one should be able to understand the meaning of the only way, because the four foundations of mindfulness means materiality and mentality, and which also means the five aggregates. In order to realize Nibbana, we must fully know the five aggregates.
在这部书的这个序里呢，有讲解到，暂时在进入讲解那部经的时候之前呢，宝禅师有介绍关系到我们要了解，正如这个《大念处经》里面，你需要的那个经的开始的那个基本的讯息，那我们需要知道的。这个基本的讯息，那个修行的方式。那首先呢，禅师有讲到那个四个忍辱，我们要证入涅槃的四个忍辱。这个四个忍辱呢，就是跟四圣谛相关的。那接着呢，他有讲到这个禅修的比喻，这如经出各种经里面所讲解的止禅和观禅的修行。在大念处经里呢，佛陀有讲解到这个止禅的修行，其中有十二种的观身的部分，那也就是这个入土洗念，观三十二身分生执念，这个四界分别观，以及九种的实体观。那接着呢，也有讲到这个禅那是，有讲到禅那是修行观察的基础，因为呢禅那的定力产生非常明亮的光，这光叫做智慧之光。那禅修者能以这智慧之光去分辨究竟色法巴拉玛达罗巴和究竟明法巴拉玛达拉玛以及他们的因，这就是。这些就是观禅的目标。那书中也有指出，在这个观禅的目标里呢，也基本上观禅的目标也可称为五蕴，就是或者是在别的经有些时候就说成是六处，或者是四念处。那我们应当了解呢，基本上呢这些不同的名词说要讲的基本上就是色法和名法而已。所以当我们了解到这个所谓的四念处是唯一的道路，也基本上呢，也就是说你需要了知色法和名法，或者是另一种归类，了知这个五蕴。所以要证悟涅槃呢，我们需要彻知五蕴。
Next is the English translation of the sutta. After these various explanations of samatha and vipassana in the preface, the next chapter is an English translation of the in and out breath section of the Mahasatipatthana Sutta.
Next 呢是那个经文的那个英语翻译。那在正在这个序里呢，讲解到这个止禅和观禅的各种解释之后，那也有接下来的翻译呢，是关系到这个大念处经里的入处洗念。
Section 1. After this translation, Venerable Sado then explains the sutta section by section. The first section is about the four foundations of mindfulness being the only way to attain Nibbana. Here, reminding us again that we need to develop all four in order to attain that.
那第一个部分，在这个翻译之后，禅师也讲解这个《大念处经》，一品一品的讲解。那第一品呢，是关系到这个的四念处作为证悟涅槃的唯一的道路。那也提醒了我们呢，说我们需要四念处全都需要培育，以便证得涅槃。
Section two, the next section is the beginning of the Samatha meditation, taking the in and out breath as the object. Other than talking about the meditation posture and bringing the mind to the breath, Venerable Sayadaw also taught how to prevent any difficulties from arising.
第二部分呢是讲到这个止禅的开始休息部分，是以先以这个入处起念为目标，那讲解了这个禅修的姿态以及如何去专注在呼吸之后呢，禅师也有讲解如何在修行中避免种种困难之升起。
Section 3 in explaining the next section, which is to understand the breath as long or as short, Venerable Sayadaw mentioned that breathing long or breathing short does not refer to the length in feet or inches, but rather it refers to the length of in time. It is also pointed out that at this stage, the nimitta may appear to some meditators. Therefore, Venerable Sayadaw gave a brief explanation on the nimitta here. However, if no nimitta appears to the meditator at this stage, then he should continue to the next stage, which is explained for him.
那第三个部分呢是就是说不论禅师有讲到关系到这个呼吸长和短的，那不论讲到是呼吸长或呼吸短，但是指的呢不是那个长尺寸的那个长短，而是呢指时间的长短。那这里呢他也有讲到这个在这个阶段呢，禅相有可能对有些禅修者会有出现这个禅相。那么，帕尔禅师也简短的讲解了关于到禅相。那无论如何，如果一个禅修者在这个阶段没有心没有注意到没有出现禅相呢，在禅修里，那他可以进入下一个步骤、下一个部分。那这在下一面继续的讲解。
Section 4. In the next section of experiencing the whole body, I shall breathe in and breathe out. It is explained that the whole body here refers to the whole body of breath, and not to the whole physical body from head to foot. That means one knows the whole breath from beginning, middle, and end at the nostril or upper lip only.
那第四部分呢是讲到经理是说到体验全身，我将吸气和呼吸。那这个全身在这里是指全的吸身，就是全息，而不是指我们的肉身，从头到脚的那个肉身。它指的是全身，是指全息身，全息从呼吸的开始、中间到结束，一直都是在这个人中口唇上端、人中上端，或者是鼻孔那一个部分，从头到尾，开始、中间、结尾都是在那边的专注的。
Section 5. In the next section of tranquilizing the formations, whenever Sayadaw explained that at this stage the meditator should only decide to tranquilize the breath and add nothing else. He should continue to know the whole breath. In this section,Venerable Sayadaw gave more explanations on nimitta and the light of wisdom. He also mentioned that meditators should avoid falling into avanga. If he can do so, then his meditation may progress from excess concentration to first jhana concentration. Here, Sayadaw gave a brief description on the progress of concentration from first jhana to fourth jhana.
第五个部分。 在讲了，在这里呢，那巴尔禅师有讲解禅修者讲到如何的平静诸心，平静。那巴尔禅师在这阶段也讲，禅修者在这个阶段纯粹就只是让那个呼吸，就是决意让呼吸更平静，在此外就没有别的东西了。那他需要他的任务仍然是持续的了知整个呼吸。那在这一部分呢，禅师也进一步的讲解到这个禅相以及智慧之光。那禅师也特别有提醒到说，禅修者应当在这阶段避免堕入有分心。那如果他能够这么做的话呢，那他的禅修将会提升从进行定到出禅。那禅师在这一部分里有继续的讲解这个如何从初禅修到实禅。
Section 6 It is mentioned that one should develop jhana as a basis for practicing vipassana. That is why the next section is about the vipassana practice. The beginning sentence of the next section is thus he advised contemplating the body internally. The word body here in vipassana is explained as two bodies, namely the mentality body, namakaya, and materiality body, rupakaya. These two are the object of vipassana meditation, and Sera begins with explaining materiality meditation. After that, he explained mentality meditation. Having discerned mentality, he is also taught to discern and analyze the materiality which mentality depends upon. Afterwards, he is to discern and define both mentality and materiality as Dhamma Rupa, mentality, materiality, both internally and externally.
那在一个修行者，这里有提到修行者呢，他应当培育禅那作为这个修行观禅的基础。这就是为什么下一部分呢是讲到观禅的修行。那下一段经文是这么说的，那禅他依自身观身，就是内在自己的身体，他依自身观身。那在这里身呢，是指在观禅里呢是有两种身，一种是名义身，也就是名身，那么 Gaya， 或者是以及色身如巴嘎呀，就是名和色，名身跟色身，这两种都是观禅的目标。那禅师开始先讲解这个色业处，那他接着呢再讲解名业处。那在以便让大家能观这个名业处呢，观这个名业处呢，他就要先教如何去辨析这个名法所依靠的这个色法，之后呢，他再引导如何辨析名法和色法为这个名色法，内在和外在的都要观。
Section 7 The next section is on the second stage of vipassana, where the meditator is to discern the causal arising and perishing away and the momentary arising and perishing away. In order to be able to discern causal arising and perishing away, he has to discern dependent origination, forward and backward order. In order to be able to discern momentary arising and perishing away, he has to discern the aggregates moment by moment arising and perishing away in order to be able to discern their impermanent suffering and oneself nature.
那第七个部分呢是观禅的这个一个阶段，那是讲到这个禅修者能够他要观这些究竟法他们的原生因缘生灭和刹那生灭，那以便要了解他们的这个因缘 生命呢，它需要修这个十二因缘顺序和逆序。那之后呢，他也要能够分辨他的刹那生命。那他要能够刹那之刹那间观这些五蕴的生命，以便能够了知和彻知他们的无常、苦和我的特征。
Section 8. The next section is on the third stage of Vipassana, where the meditator attains to higher and higher Vipassana knowledges. At this stage, if the meditator is successful, he will attain up to the Vipassana knowledge called change of lineage knowledge. In Pali, it is called Gocharvijnana.
接着呢是观禅的第三个阶段，就是禅修者会证得更高的观禅的智慧。在这阶段，如果一个禅修者成功的话呢，他会直到修到这个观禅的这个种性智，那在巴利的种性智叫 Gotrabhunyana。
Section 9. After that, in the next section, it is the description of the fourth and the last stage of Vipassana, where the meditator attains the path knowledges and fruition knowledges.This concludes the description of the bhikkhu who practices Anapanasati as taught in Mahasatipatthana Sutta.
再下一步呢是观禅的第四部分，就是禅修者证入这个道智和果智。那这就总结了在大念初经里面对这个入处习念和安波念的修行。
Next book is the Knowing and Seeing, which we have described yesterday. It is a brief one. Knowing and Seeing is a compilation of the Dharma talks given by Venerable Pao Xiaodo during the first retreat he gave in Taiwan in 1998. It was first published in 1999.And the book I'm referring to now is the fourth revised edition published in 2010. It has about 271 pages.
接着呢是熟识之见这本书。这熟识之见这本书呢是根据帕尔禅师在1998年在台湾办禅修营的时候呢所给的佛法开示整理。的出版的书，他最初在1999年出版。那现在我是所用的这个如实之见这个版本呢，所介绍的是第四版，2010年出版的第四版。它总共有271面。
In the first talk, Venerable Sayadaw discussed about why and what is meditation. In describing how to meditate.Meditation on in and out breath is explained until the attainment of jhana concentration.
在第一讲里呢，法华禅师有讲解到什么是禅修和为什么要修禅。那讲到如何修禅呢？禅师有讲解这个入处习念如何修，以致修到入禅定。
In the second talk, it is shown that.When a meditator is successful in Anapana meditation, he can go on to develop other Samatha meditation. In this talk, the practice of 32 parts of the body meditation, skeleton meditation, and 10 kasina meditation are discussed. The four immaterial Arupa jhanas are also discussed here.
在第二讲里呢，那禅修者也禅师有讲到这个。一个人禅修者一旦在这个入处习念、安波念成功过后呢，他可以进而去修学其他的子禅业处。在这一讲里呢，那他是有介绍讲到32身分的修法，以及白骨观的修法，还有10种偏注定的修法。那这里呢，这一讲里呢，也同时有讲到这个4种无色禅的修法。
In the third talk, Xiaodaw further his discussion on other subjects of Samatha meditation. These are loving kindness meditation, compassion meditation, karuna, sympathetic joy meditation, mudita, equanimity meditation, upekkha, buddha recollection, buddha anusati, foulness meditation, asubha, and death meditation, paradanusati.
在第三堂讲座里呢，禅师有讲到其他的止禅业缺的修法，那就是慈心禅 metta、悲心禅 karuna、喜心禅 mudita、舍心禅 upekkha、佛垂念 buddha anusati、不净观 asubha 和死随念 marana anusati。
The fourth talk is about discerning materiality.In order to do so, one first practice the four elements meditation. After that, you should be able to see that materiality is nothing but small particles called rupa kalpa. To discern ultimate reality of materiality, you need to see that the individual type of rupa kalpa consists of elements dhatu. These are discussed briefly in this talk.
在第四堂讲座里呢这是关系到设法的。那要体验这个设法呢，首先一个禅修者需要修学四界分别观。那在那之后呢，他要尝试看到这些设法呢，他基本上呢也只是很小的那个粒子组合成我们叫做 Rupa Kalpa 设具。那要看到了这些旧设法的这些旧净的成分，旧净设法要看到每一个设具里呢，都是由这些旧净设法或者是组合而成，那些或者我们叫做戒大度，这是在这个讲座里呢有简短的讨论。
The fifth talk is about discerning mentality. Here, Venerable Sera discussed about discerning jhana mental process.Mind door processes and the five door processes internally and externally.
第五堂讲座是关系到这个明法的。那在这里，Paul禅师呢有讲解这个禅定的心入过程、一门心入过程、五门心入过程，有讲解内在和外在的状况的观法。
The sixth talk is about discerning the links of.Dependent on origination. In this talk, Venerable Sera briefly discussed how to discern past and future, mentioning that the meditator should discern the causal relation between past, present, and future five aggregates.
第六个讲座呢是关系到的十二缘起的。讲到在这讲座里呢，禅师有简短的讲解如何去辨析过去和未来。也讲到禅修者呢需要去辨析这过去、现在和未来五蕴他们之间的因果关系。
The seventh talk is about developing the vipassana knowledges to see nirvana. In vipassana meditation, the meditator should gradually be able to discern the three characteristics of impermanence, suffering, and non-self information according to different categories.Attaining the higher vipassana knowledges, the meditator then attains path and fruition knowledge, realizing nirvana.
第七堂讲座呢是讲这个对观禅的智慧的培育，直到证悟涅槃。那在这观禅里，禅修者应当逐步的去观察那三相，就是无常、苦。和我就是诸行的三相的无常苦我，然后他们的不同的种类，个别的种类都要观为无常苦我，然后直到证得更高的观禅的智慧，然后最终体证道智果智证悟涅槃。
The eighth talk was given on Vesak Day 1998. In this talk, Venerable Sera points out what are the wishes that Buddha has for his.Disciples. That is, as a disciple of the Buddha, one should learn the Buddha's teaching thoroughly, practice the Buddha's teaching, and finally develop them until the attainment of Nirvana. In other words, to reach the end of rounds of rebirth, we must practice the Noble Eightfold Path.
在第八堂讲座里呢，这个讲座是在这个 位赛节那天，或者佛陀日的那天，1998年的位赛节所给的开始。那在这里呢，这个泡禅师有讲解佛陀给对于弟子们的期盼是什么。那也就是作为一个佛弟子，我们一个佛弟子应当修学，彻底的了学习佛陀的教法，学习修行佛陀的教法，培育佛陀的教法，直到最终证悟涅槃。换句话说，也就是我们需要修学八圣道，直到了生脱世，跳出轮回。
In the ninth talk, which is the last chapter in this book, Venerable Sera discusses about the most superior kind of offering with reference to the Dakina Vibhanga Sutta. Here I'd like to mention that at the end of each talk, there is a question and answer session. The questions asked are of various topics, mostly concerning meditation.
在第九堂讲座里，也就是这个书的最后一品呢，禅师有讲解这个布施怎么样是形成最殊胜的布施，是根据 Dakina Vibhanga Sutta 这部经所讲解的这个布施。然后在这边一个，这里我要讲的就是在禅师的每一堂讲座的结尾呢，都有这个问答，那么种种的问题，各个课题的问题，关系到禅修的，主要是关系到禅修的，都有得到解答。
I'd like to skip to the next book, which is Towards Eternal Peace, because of time factor. The title of the next book is Towards Eternal Peace. In the year 2000, Venerable Pao Xiaoliao was invited to give a talk in the United Nations on world peace. Xiaoliao has prepared his talk, but he was not able to attend due to illness. The talk was never delivered. This book is the transcription of that talk and was first published in 2005. It has about 23 pages. Xiaoliao first discussed about how jealousy and misery has prevented beings from living in peace and harmony. To overcome jealousy and misery, they should practice the Buddha's middle path of morality, concentration, and wisdom. These three practices are briefly discussed here. So in order to achieve world peace, people should undertake the noble practice of the Buddha.
Yeah. Yeah.与时间关系呢，要跳过这个安波尼的那本书，来讲到接着是讲朝往永恒的极境。那这本书是在2007年，泡禅师被邀请在这个联合国讲解世界和平。那禅师已经准备了他的开始，但是呢，因为生病的缘故，没办法去开始，那么呢去演讲，所以这个演讲呢并没有完成。但是呢，这个讲座准备好的是在2005年的出版，总共有23面。在这本书里呢，禅师首先谈到如何这个妒忌跟吝啬，让人们呢无法，让众生无法活在这个祥和和和谐和安宁中。那要克服妒忌和吝啬呢？那人们应当依据佛陀的中道，也就是戒定慧来实践来修行。所以这戒定慧的修行呢，在这本书里有简短的讲解。那也就是说，如果人们希望得到世界和平呢，应当修学佛陀所讲的这个崇高的这个修行。
So the next book will be Workings of Karma. The next book, the Workings of Karma, which I'm describing, is published in 2008. It has 400 pages divided into 6 chapters. Karma can be a very complex subject consisting of many interconnected principles. However, We are fortunate that Venerable Pao Siada gave us a systematic explanation on the workings of karma through this book. It is a detailed analysis and discussion of the workings of karma in accordance with the various Pali texts such as Vinaya, Suttas, Abhidhamma, and their relevant commentaries and sub-commentaries. Chapter 1 and 2. Among the six chapters of this book, in the first two chapters, Venerable Siyarao gave a discussion on the rounds of rebirth, on how beings are reborn again and again from one world to another, or within one world. The two main causes for this ongoing process are ignorance and craving. The discussion in both of these chapters are based on Gadula Bada Sutta and Dutiya Gadula Bada Sutta respectively. The next chapter, chapter 3, is the longest chapter in this book. This chapter alone has 190 pages. It is in this chapter that Venerable Siyarao gave an analytical and extensive discussion on the workings of karma. Venerable Siyarao begins this chapter by telling us that it is the Buddha's power to fully comprehend karma and karma's result. However, as a disciple of the Buddha, he is able to practice insight meditation. Then he may be able to see the connections between certain karmas and their results. Therefore, it is mentioned here that it is possible for a disciple to gain partial understanding of the workings of karma. In fact, Sada also pointed out that to have a right understanding of the five aggregates, we need to understand dependent origination and cessation, which means we need to understand the workings of karma by practicing proper insight meditation and attaining the cause apprehending knowledge, Paccaya Parinigaha Yana. After that, Siyarao gave a brief definition of the word karma so that we can understand that volition, Chetana, is the mental factor responsible for creating karma. Then, Venerable Siyarao next discussed on the impossible and possible results. That is, impossible that unwholesome karma will produce wholesome result, and it is impossible that wholesome karma will produce unwholesome result. So also, it is possible that unwholesome karma will produce unwholesome result, and it is possible that wholesome karma will produce wholesome results. Siyarao then discussed what are the unwholesome root consciousness and wholesome root consciousness. He then further discussed that the outcome of a karma depend on whether it is of wholesome or unwholesome root consciousness, whether it is associated or dissociated with knowledge, whether it is prompted or unprompted, whether it is inferior or superior. Talking about wholesome consciousness, he discussed about the three bases for making merits. These are the three ways to accomplish wholesome karma, which are offering, morality, and meditation. In discussing about bhavana, meditation, Sarah explained about both samatha and vipassana meditation. On page 106, when describing about dependent origination, Sarah mentioned briefly how a meditator can discern his past life with the help of his meditational light of wisdom. Next, Siyarao also explained what are the 10 unwholesome karma and 10 wholesome karma. He also mentioned about the attainment of the end of rebirth or attainment of path and fruition. However, in order for us to be able to attain path and fruition, Siyarao also pointed out the kind of past practice necessary for that attainment, which is called knowledge and conduct, vijacharana. Then Siyarao further explained the four categories of karma according to when those karma take effect. And then Siyarao also explained another four categories of karma according to the type of karma that takes effect first. Venerable Siyarao concludes this chapter by explaining what are the four types of achievement which disable certain unwholesome karma from producing their result, and what are the four types of failure which disable certain certain wholesome karma from producing the result. The Pali achievement is called sampatti, and failure is called vipatti.
接着呢是关系到这个业的运作这本书，这浓缩的翻译。那这业是一个很复杂的课题，牵涉到很多的这个法则在里头。那我们很幸运的巴尔禅师在这部《业的运作》这本书里呢，给一个很详尽的、很系统的讲解。那这是根据不同的巴利圣典，这个律藏、经藏、阿毗达摩以及相关的注释和附注，说出来的这个开示。那在这个这本书的六个部分里呢，前两个部分，那前两章呢，帕尔禅师有讲解到这个轮回，讲解如何众生是不断的轮回，从一个世间到另一个世间，或者在同一个世间里继续的轮回。主要轮回的因素是无明跟贪爱。那这是根据皮带束缚经和第二皮带束缚经所做出的开始。那第三章里呢是最长的章节，这是有190面呢，禅师讲解详尽的讲解这个业的运作。首先呢，禅师讲佛只有佛陀才能够彻底全面的彻彻底底的了知业和业的他们的业报或者果报。那但是作为佛弟子呢，我也是可以通过修行去看到一些业和他们的果报的，所以也就是说，对于业的运作是可以，弟子们是可以有部分的了解的。那以便如果我们要了解这个五蕴，那我们禅师也说，我们应当需要去了解缘生跟缘灭，也就是说，我们需要通过这个内观智慧去证的这个缘色受持阿加哈巴里嘎亚呢。那禅师也简短的讲解这个业这个意思，以便也让我们了解在这个业的要造业的这个过程中，我们的一个心所叫杰他呢，也就是翻译成思，是主要的心所，去让我们促成我们造业的。那禅师也有说到什么是不可能的结果和可能的结果。那不可能的事呢，就是不善业会产生善报，这是不可能的，也同样也不可能的是善业产生恶报，这也是不可能的。而善不善业产生不善报，善业产生善报，这是可能的。所以禅师也讲到这个不善的心事和善的心事，然后到底怎么样它是善和不善的心事，他们是否有伴随着这个智慧，有智或者是无智，有形或者是无形，或者是低劣或者是殊胜，也有讲解到。那讲到这个善心事，也谈到三种累积功德的那个基础，就是布施、持戒和修禅。但谈到这个抛呢，这个禅呢，抛禅师有讲到这个止禅和观禅，在接着也有讲到这个缘起。如果一个禅修者能够通过他禅修的智慧之光去观照过去式。那禅师有讲到十不善法和十种善法，那如何不善法导致堕落到这个畜生道、恶鬼道甚至地狱道，那善法如何让他投身到人界和天界。也有讲到这个轮回的宗旨和道和果的体证。那禅师也说到呢，以便证得这个圣道圣果，我们是有需要拥有这个基础，这个 名和行的基础 ，vijara， 名和行的基础，名是指智慧，行有一些相关的善行。那在这里呢，有提到一些故事，经历的那些故事如何它的起作用，因为或者以及也有说到，如果因为不缺乏这个名和行所带来的结果。那接着呢，禅师有讲到世俗的业以及他们这个业产生的这个果报和运作，如何导致未来的生命和轮回等等。然后也有说到怎么样他有些业不无法起作用。那也有不同的分类，讲的业的分类也有说，有一种是分类是哪一些业先成熟的。那这方面又提到四种业，如中业、惯性业、临终业和已作业等等的业的情况。所以禅师在这里呢讲解十二种的业，然后也引述巴利圣典里面的许多的故事。那也总结，禅师在这里总结到这个如何不善业产生它的果报，然后也有什么因素，四种因素能够阻止不善业然后起作用产生果报，然后也有四种失败的因素能够摧毁让善业不能产生果报，这个都有说到，这是属于成就三八地和这个失败的因和失败叫为八地。
Would you like to go directly to the comments?
Here I would like to comment that so far some of these books has two important results. Firstly, some of these books are a good introduction to meditation for many new meditators, especially these two books, Knowing and Seeing and Light of Wisdom.These two books were published in the earlier years around 1997. At that time, there are not many books on Samatha Vipassana, and Venerable Sayadaw has not gone to teach overseas yet. When those who are interested in meditation read these two books, it was a pleasant surprise for them that there is still a place to practice Samatha Vipassana. That is, one first develops concentration up to at least excess concentration or absorption concentration and develops.One's wisdom by way of insight meditation. So these books made them realize that it is still possible for one to develop up to absorption jhana concentration. That is, it is still attainable today. For that reason, many new meditators came to meditate after reading these books. The second effect in publishing these two books is that some of these books became a good theoretical guidance for those already meditating in Paolong Monastery.There are many of those who are successful in their meditation who has never attend any Buddhist college. So some of these books give them a very good theoretical background to what they have attained. So may you be able to practice meditation and attain to what is written in these books.
最后的结论是这些书呢出版的这些书带来了两个主要的那个效果。首先呢，这些书呢都是对这个禅修初学的禅修者是有一种很好的介绍，特别是如实之见和智慧之光。这两本书呢是在早期，这大概1997年的时候呢就发布的。那在当时呢，禅师还没有到国外去交禅，那过去到止禅和观禅的书籍并不多。那对于那些兴趣的人呢，在这方面，他们发现到有这样的书，他们会感到一种惊喜，而且呢，能够从这个书里发现到有还有地方。竟然还有地方可以修学止禅和观禅的，所以在这里 Sensui 讲解到如何一个人的比喻定力到至少到进行定或安止定，然后呢再去比喻，通过观察去比喻智慧。所以通过这些书呢，他们了发现到是可能的，能够修要修这个禅那的安止定是可能的，在这今天这个时代仍然可以证得禅那。所以因此呢，许多人呢因为读了这些书而来修禅。那第二个效果呢，是出版这两本书，这两本书呢还有其他的都成在对这个八号禅林呢，对于他们来修禅者呢是一个很好的理论基础和引导。那因为呢，而且呢在这里呢有许多人也没有去过佛学院读书，但是呢通过这里的学习能够在禅修上得到成就。所以这些书籍给禅修者呢非常好的理论的基础，然后愿你们大家都能够来修禅，也证得这些书里面所讲解的法。
非常感谢净法长老的发表。 Thank you very much for Bante Damasubo's presentation。 对昨天没来的那个就是会议的参加者，我今天要特别介绍一下吉祥尊者。吉祥尊者呢是我已经见识到他的翻译的能力，他其实是马来西亚多帅天禅林的住持。我们今天请的都是住持级的来发表所以我们非常感谢他。好，那我们的时间呢可能稍微可以稍微调整一下那接下来是我们先请智行长老发表，然后那个因为我们原来设计有中场休息半小时，中午休息两小时，就是因为要把这个做活动的弹性，所以待会我会在时间的部分呢做一些简单的调整。好，那接着我们就请智行长老 next we will invite Bante Yamachana to have a presentation。
我们各位尊者、各位朋友，然后各位学家，大家好。我也是建功大学的学生。为什么？我来这边学过国语一年，可是我的中文没有那么好，所以真的是我的文章应该那个中文的，可是我学不过的。所以呢，我的那个文章现在是那个英文版的，然后。我们的班级他帮忙我翻译。我们跑森林的最重要的most vulnerable poor shadows is most important stability and the community leader is very important for us. And then this scripture and Mr. Peace is published in Taiwan in 1998. So, when was this Mr. Peace Nibbana Kamini Pribada published in Taiwan for first edition in 1998? This is, I think, very important question for us, because when Shadow come to Taiwan and then conduct first seminar, at the time, the first question is this question.
那关系到为什么宝禅师的巨著这个去往涅槃之道是在1998年在台湾出版的，那这是最初禅师到来这里也关系到这个是说要面对的主要的这个问题。
In 1998 at the time most of the religious booksand Myanmar language are published in Myanmar. But Paul Shadow's masterpiece was published in abroad and delivered to Taiwan, Myanmar, and then we offer many senior monks like this. So it was unusual. The main reason of publishing in Taiwan is because of Myanmar publishing law. There's in the Myanmar publishing law,If any religious author was to publish their works, They have to send their work to Myanmar Sangha Council. The Myanmar senior monks and lay officer used to check and give permission to publish if there is a new problem.
在这里呢，大多数在缅甸文的那个宗教的书呢，书籍呢，都是在缅甸出版的。缅文的书籍是在缅甸出版的。但是呢，报禅师的去处是在外国出版，然后呢送回缅甸，这是不寻常的事。主要的原因呢，是在海外出版这个书籍呢，是关系到这个缅甸的出版的法规。在这个缅甸的法规里呢，任何一个宗教的作者、写作者，他们要出版他们的书籍呢，需要先送给这个缅甸僧团理事会的审核。那里的长者居士们呢，将会检查，然后呢才会批改的允许这个书籍的出版。如果没有经过这样子的审核呢，是有问题的。
所以 Paul Theodore also sent his work to Myanmar Sangha Council in 1997. They checked, suggested to remove some sentences because of some reason and gave permission to publish on 5th July 1998.The reason of suggestion to remove are not acceptable for Paul Theodore. So Theodore mentioned to the Myanmar Sangha Council, but nobody replied to Theodore. Theodore wished to publish his work without removing any of sentence. But Myanmar Sangha Council gave permission to publish if Theodore agreed to remove some sentences. Because of this reason, Theodore had to decide to publishhis work in Taiwan for the first edition.
那在1997年，宝禅师也把他的著作呈给缅甸僧团理事会，他们检查过后呢，然后建议把里面的一些句子删除，然后呢，如果删除了，他们允许在1998年7月五号，然后出版。那他们要删除这个句处里面的那些一些文句的理由，是宝禅师所不能够接受的。那宝禅师把他的意见反映给缅甸僧团理事会，但是他们没有回应。于是宝禅师他要在没有删改他的著作的情况下出版。但是呢，这个缅甸僧团理事会的条件是，如果禅师同意删改那些文句，那他们会允许这个出版。基于这个原因呢，为了不要删改他的著作，那巴尔禅师决定在1998年在台湾出版这个他的巨著《去往涅槃之道》的这第一版。
There's too much rumor for this publication in Taiwan. Some people misunderstood like this. Paul Theodore's Mr. Beast was not allowed to publish in Myanmar. Therefore, it was published in Taiwan. The reason may be because of edition method taught in the Mr. Beast may be different from the Tipitaka. Theodore already clearly said that it was not true. Myanmar Sangha Council.Have already given permission to publish if Paul Theodore agreed to remove some sentences from his work.
关系到这个出版呢，有太多的谣传和谣言。那有些人呢是如此误解的，他们说帕尔禅师的巨著是不被在缅甸是不被允许出版的，这是所以呢他才在国外出版。那原因呢是，他们猜想，必然是。这个禅师的著作是跟三藏所相违背的。那禅师很清楚地说了，这并不是如此，情况并不是如此。其实
缅甸僧团理事会已经允许禅师出版，只是要禅师消除删除里面的一些章句而已。
So many people who wish to meditate misunderstood. They hesitate to read the masterpiece because of the rumor. Certainly, a monk also misunderstood and criticized without reading Shandor's masterpiece. And Nyingma Council, Sangha Council also he noticed Shandor's work because after that, Shandor also trying to send to get permission the new small book. But the officer and Sangha Council noticed and then they checked for a long time.So there is delay to publish Shandor's works. And then Shandor December also they try to get permission at the paper, but the Sangha Council and officer they notice and then they take long time to check. Because of that reason, they are delayed to publish in Myanmar Shandor's books and Shandor December books.
很多人想要打坐的人呢，但是他们对这方面呢就产生了误解，于是因为这个谣传的缘故呢，他们由于要阅读这个禅师的居住，那有些年轻的比丘呢也误解，他们在没有读到这些居住的之前呢，就已经先批判。那这个僧团理事会以及一些。居士官员们呢，他们对于禅师的这个著作和其他弟子们所写的著作呢，是 很小心的，而且耽误不断的有耽误，所以其中呢也出一些小册子，那他们也都很认真的很检查，而且也耽误，所以耽误了那个出版的过程。那有些，于是呢，这个巴奥在巴奥的这个生前生团的理事呢，他们就讨论，然后就建议呢，禅师呢，再把那几句话依这个缅甸生团理事会的建议，把那几句话删除，然后呢，在缅甸出版。
So, Pao Sangha Council, Pao Sangha Committee discuss each other and then ask to Shandor, and then Shandor also has to agree to remove some sentences to have permission to publish. So, this masterpiece was printed and published in Myanmar for second edition in 2004.
那因为如此呢，禅师必须也就为了让这个书能够在缅甸出版的，禅师必须同意把那一些字句、一些章句呢，然后在著作里的章句呢删除，以便能够在缅甸出版。所以在2004年，宝禅师的居住去往涅槃之道是根据。这个僧团理事会的指示，把那些章句删除过后呢，然后在缅甸得以出版。
So I want to discuss in my paper four things. First one is the briefly introduction of a Shandor masterpiece. Second one is the first which I suggest to remove by Nyingma Sangha Council.That one is Paul Shandor's view regarding with the Sangha Council suggestion. Fourth one is Shandor masterpiece to edition.
在此呢，我会简单的讲解那。缅甸僧团理事会所建议的要消除的删除的那些那个事实，然后呢，巴奥禅师在这方 的他们的以及他们的理由，以上巴尔禅师对这方以及他们的理由，巴尔禅师对这点的看法，还有呢就是第二版这个在缅甸出版的这第二版，以及他们之间第一版的第二版之间的差别。
So, to understand why Xiaoduo or Mr. Bisu was published in Taiwan, we need to know what are described in the masterpiece. The masterpiece is in five volumes, and there were totally 3,319 pages without counting the endings. There are nine chapters, and the whole masterpiece is following.
那要了解禅师的巨著在为什么在台湾出版呢，我们需要了解这巨著里所讲的是什么。这巨著里呢是分成五册，总共是3319页，然后这是除掉那个目录和后面的这个 index， 然后总共有九章，整个巨著里总共有九章。
So, at the first volume, there are four chapters, and then Xiaoduo mentioned really meaning of the samadhi and how to practice attain the samadhi and how to discern materiality. The real meaning of the samadhi, which is able to see materiality and mentality, is.Jhana Samadhi or Upachara Samadhi. This is specialized in the first volume.
That 在第一册里呢是有四章，那禅师讲解到这个定的主要意识，如何证得这个定力，然后如何去辨析色法。然后这个定的意思呢，是能够辨析色法跟明法的定呢，是这个安止定，或者是禅那的定力，或者是进行定。那要证得这个进行定或安止定呢，它需要有系统的修行。
And the second volume, a fifth chapter, which is intended to discern the mentality, is in the second volume. So I mentioned about how to discern the mentality, quoting many sutta, commentary, and sub-commentary. According to Panikana, Meditator must discern the kind of a mentality. So I mentioned in the second volume like this.
在第二册呢，禅师有讲解到如何观明法。禅师引述了许多的经，这个注释和附注，然后再根据这个巴利圣典，一个禅修者需要以是一种观法去观明法。
So that value is, I think this is the most important one, because of the sixth chapter, which I mentioned about pictures about the divine origination is in this volume.Without knowing and seeing the divine origination, nobody can attain the Nibbana. There's a very importance. Therefore, Xiaoduo mentioned the way of practicing to know divine origination.
那第三册里呢，是关系到这个缘起的。没有了知，没有如实知见，没有了知这个缘起呢，没有人能够证得涅槃的。所以这是非常重要的，因此呢，禅师就在这一部分的这一章里呢，讲解如何去修学以便证得的缘起。
The divine origination is a cause and effect of the mentality and materiality. There are five past cause, five present effect, five present cause, and five future present. Five present effect.Appear in this existence because of five past causes. Because of five present causes, five future effects will appear in the future existence. Therefore, Informator want to know the cause of the present effect. He needs to discern the cause from past existence.
在缘起呢，是就是指这个名色法他们的因果关系。那五种过去因，五种现在果，五种现在因，五种未来果。那现在的五果，这是在这一生升起，是因为过去的五因。那因为现在的五因，那也会导致未来的生命升起，未来的五果。所以，如果一个禅修者需要知道现在的果报，他们的因，那他需要去修学，去辨析过去世的因。
The second chapter in this fourth volume, it describes characteristic, function, notification, and reciprocal of every materiality and mentality known as the Kanadi Sugar and Party, to break down the component and to see the ultimate reality and meditator must try to see the Lekhanadi Dukkha. It is impossible to practice Vipassana Bhavana without seeing the ultimate maturity in mentality. This is different from the Nyama tradition meditation method.
那第四册是这个第四册里呢，这个第七章是在第四册里，他讲解到相、作用、现起和静因的每一种设法、每一种名法的相、作用、现起、静因，就是在这个巴利的这个拉卡纳迪这个里有讲解到。那这个修法呢，是要进一步的去破除秘籍，以便彻知究竟设法和究竟名法。所以要达到这一点，就需要去做的，即如此的细修。因为呢，如果没有观到究竟名色法呢，是不可能修学观禅的。
So,
还有就是这种修法呢，在缅甸跟一般传统的修法呢是有不同的。
So the last one.The eighth chapter and ninth chapter are in the fifth volume. In the eighth chapter, Shadow mentioned about to practice Vipassana meditation systematically and mentioned about 10 inside knowledge, Vipassana Jnana step by step. To attain the inside knowledge, meditator must try diligently the 14th way of Vipassana Bhavana known as 14 Tor. At the last chapter, he mentionedHow to practice the rest of the Samatha Bhavana meditation to support the Vipassana Bhavana and the last chapter.
那在第五册里的是有第八章和第九章，那禅师讲解如何有系统的方式修学观禅。这里呢，来讲解到这个观禅里的十种这个。观智在逐步逐步的修的十观禅里的其中十种的观智，那也讲到呢，一个禅修者需要精勤的修学观禅里有一种四十种度的修法，这是从四十种观法，那也有讲到还有剩余的还没有修学的这个子禅，如何的修学以便能够支撑和支持观禅。
So there are 3,319 pages in Paul Shadow's recipe. Sangha Council suggests to remove only 49 sentences from 14 plays. If we combine the 49 sentences together, it may be in the 4.5 page. They didn't suggest to remove any subject or any chapter.They only suggest to remove only 49 sentences.
讲到在这个巨著里呢，总共3319页的巨著， 这个僧团的僧团理事会是建议删除在14个部地方删除49个句子。那如果我们把这49个句子结合在一起呢，他们可能大约是4面半。那僧团理事会并没有说要删除任何一章或者是任何一个课题。那
When we read the suggestion of the Sangha Council, we realize that this subject is to remove 49 sentences because of three reasons. Number one is Myanmar Publishing Law. Second one is instruction which is according to the Myanmar traditional meditation method.That is one is a quotation way.
然后如果我们去阅读这个僧团理事会他们的建议，我们会发现到他们要建议删除的49个句子是基于以下的理由。第一是缅甸的出版法规。那这些49句话里的此事呢，是有违背缅甸的传统修禅方法，这是一点。还有呢，就是他的引述的方式。
So, according to Myanmar Meditation Law, one meditation teacher should not criticize other method and other meditator. Myanmar Sangha Council think that criticizing sentences from this place of the Mr. Bean's criticize other meditation method.For example, if someone say, meditator must not try to see materiality and mentality which occur in past and future, he should dharma as a dharma, atama. Example 2, if someone believes that it is impossible to know and see the materiality and mentality which occur in past and future, it is meaningful for him to think divine origination.This kind of belief also regards Dhamma as an Adhamma.
那根据缅甸的出版法规呢，一个禅修导师不应当批评其他的禅修方法或其他禅修者的禅修方法。在缅甸的僧团理事会呢，认为在这个注里的六个地方的27个句子是有批评到其他的禅修方法的。比如说这个句子说，如果有人说一个禅修者必须不要尝试去看过去和未来的明法和色法，那他就把法讲成非法。那另一个句子是说，如果一个人他相信不可能看到过去和未来的名色法，那对他来说呢，是要看这个缘起是没有意义的。那这种信仰这种表达呢，也是把法讲成非法。
Two is some phrase that again to the Myanmar traditional meditation method. I've already mentioned above, sort of especially to say descend the mentality and materiality. But also the traditional method in Myanmar didn't try to descend 11 kind ofMaturity and mentality. Sando repeatedly mentioned about the 11 kind of maturity and mentality in his masterpiece, having conditioned Manisutas and Samyutthanikaya. Among this description, descending the person mentality and maturity is more famous. Therefore, expression andThe masterpieces are different from the Myanmar traditional meditation method, but it is not different from Pali Canon. Myanmar Sangha Council didn't want to appear any problem regarding with this kind of disagreement. Therefore, they suggested to remove some sentences related to descending the path. They are too many this kind of instruction in shadow semester, which but they only suggested to remove 19 sentences from the seven place of the whole masterpiece.
另一点呢，是关系到这个跟缅甸传统禅法的抵触。那缅甸传统的禅法呢，是没有指导去观，是以这个以十一种方式去观这个究竟，去观名色法的。那但是呢，巴尔禅师在著作里却一而再的强调，提到这名色法的十一种观法。这是而且呢，而且有引述许多的经，特别是相应部的经。那在这十一种观法里面呢，最知名的就是观过去名色法。那这些只是呢，在缅甸的传统的禅法里呢是不一样的，但是呢，跟缅甸传统禅法不一样，但是却没有跟巴利圣典不一样。那缅甸的僧团理事会呢，不想这一种的论点呢造成任何的问题，所以呢，他们建议删除这关系到管过去究竟过去名色法的这些章句。但是呢，在帕尔禅师的这个巨著里，有太多这样的指示去观的过去的未来的目标，所以但是呢，这个僧团理事会呢，只请求说在十一处里删除十九个句子。
So the third one is a position way. According to the religion publisher law in Myanmar, if one wish to quote the Pali canon, they can quote correctly, but they should not quote to prove their personal idea. So they misunderstand that Paul Shadow make quotation twice to improve his personal idea.
根据这个缅甸的这个出版宗教书籍出版的法规呢，如果一个人要引述这个巴利圣典或者是注释以及那个附注，那他不应当引述来认可某一个自己的想法。那他们有一个错觉，错误的误解，以为在两个地方两个引述里呢，巴尔禅师是有如此的引述的，以此他们建议消除这两种引述。
Paul Shadow replied the Dhamma Council regarding with his suggestion. He never criticized anyone but just wrote according to the Pali canon. His steps may not be exactly same with the traditional meditation method, but it is not different from the Pali canonHe never made any Pali canon to approach his personal idea, but only quoting Pali canon repeatedly to prove exploration from the Pali canon. Therefore, he asked again permission to publish without removing anything, but nobody replied. So Shadow had to decide his disciple to publish in Taiwan for the first edition.
No.禅师对于这个僧团理事会的建议呢是有回应的，他没有批判任何人，只是依巴利圣典而写他的著作。他的巨著虽然或许在不能跟缅甸传统的禅法一模一样，但是呢却没有违背巴利圣典注释和附注。他没有引述任何巴利圣典以便巩固自己的论点，但是就纯粹只是引述巴利圣典而已。所以他请求呢，在没有删改任何一部分的情况之下做出版，但是呢没有得到回应。于是呢，帕瓦禅师允许他弟子在台湾出版这个巨著的第一版。
So, And the third of Mr. B, third rule that Mr. B, according to Pali Canon, sign regarding with the descendant, the past and future alternability are similar to present of the teaching. But he didn't present anyone. And then, three, two, some meditation method and traditional meditation method is not exactly the same. This is also one reason. Then regarding the quotation method, Shadow also didn't make any wrong quotation. Shadow only right quotation, Shadow say like this. But after publishing, there's a maybe too much rumor. And then the Shadows, the other small books also delayed to publish. Very not easy to get the permission. Because of this reason, Pao sang a comedy, discuss each other, and then I found Xiaodo. Xiaodo also agreed to remove 49 sentences from the 40 place. Even remove the 49 sentences from the 40 place, the essence of the Master B is not wrong meaning, and then even good. So, Shadow had to decide to get permission. He had to remove the 49 sentences. And then we get the permission to publish in Myanmar. So we, and this Pao Shadow's masterpiece, Nibbana Kamdhita, was published in Myanmar for the second edition in 2004.
禅师写这本巨著呢，只是纯粹根据巴利圣典而已。那有一些的表达呢，是关系到看旧过去和未来的究竟法。那看起来呢，好像在批判其他的教法，其实呢，它并不是要批判其他的教法，只是依巴利圣典而讲解而已。那关系到这个，在这个巨著里面所讲解的修行呢，是跟其他的传统的禅法是没有不同的，但是呢，确实都是在圣典里有记载的。那关于他引述的方法呢，其实禅师引述那个巴利圣典的那个方式呢，也都不是要巩固什么自己个人的主观意识，而是纯粹只是要把这个巴利圣典呢详尽的拿来讲解。那所以由于这个外头流传的那些不善的谣传呢，让关系到说禅师的著作呢不能够得到批准在缅甸出版，所以当时呢也这个谣传呢也带来了一些问题。所以巴奥的这个僧团理事会呢僧团委员会呢，他们都请求巴奥禅师呢说就退让，也删除在14个地方删除49个句子。那禅师后来也同意了，虽然是删除了这49个句子，但是呢整个巨著它的内涵是依然得以保存，重要的精华内涵都得以保存。所以禅师呢也就决定了删除，那么呢还一次呢得到圣团理事会的通过，允许在缅甸出版这本巨著的第二版，那是在2004年。
So there's not too much difference between the two editions. The first edition was published in Taiwan without removing anything. The second edition was published in Myanmar after removing 49 sentences. Only this different. Everything is the same.
基本上呢，这第一版跟第二版呢，他们的差距呢，也不是不基本上呢是不大的，因为第一版在台湾出版的是原原本本，没有移除那49句的这个句子，在缅甸呢是已经删除了的49个句子，但是呢，他们之间的缅甸版跟台湾版呢，他们的差距是不大的。
So normally there's not too much room or regarding what the policy and the semester fees, even the government, but the reason or a lot of some people know Myanmar Standard Council already given permission to publish in Myanmar since 1998. And they also know the reason of publishing in Taiwan. And then there's also, it was published in Myanmar for a second edition. So more scholar means foreign medical teacher from various countries come to our medicine center and meditate. More and more senior men from various medicine center also come to practice. Therefore, the room is not too much now.
Now, 很多人现在终于都知道，其实巴尔禅师在1998年已经得到身传理事会的允许，只是当时是那个条件列下的条件。但是其实1998年已经允许出版了那些著作，也了解到为什么那个巨著在台湾出版，第一版在台湾出版，那么他们也知道了这个第二版在缅甸出版的这第二版。这个居住，那么也因此呢，现在许多的外国的禅修者都陆陆续续，以及来自全国缅甸全国各地的禅修者陆陆续续到来这个禅修中心来修禅，所以呢，现在呢，这个谣传呢已经不再持续了。
There are four main points in the Mr. Beast which is different from the Myanmar traditional meditation method. First one is to practice the Samadhi Bhavana, to attain Jhana Samadhi, and practice the four elements meditation to attain the Upacara Samadhi. The second one is interesting to see the Rupa Kalapa, ultimate materiality, and Nama, ultimate materiality. The third one is to discern 11 kind of materiality and mentality. The last one is trying to see previous existing to get the Vajrayana. It is difficult to assert about discerning the previous existing first maturity and mentality or one who strongly believes in Myanmar traditional meditation method. These three points are main reason for Myanmar Standard Council such as to remove some of the 49 sentences.
在这个据处理呢，有四个要点呢，是跟缅甸的传统禅法是不同的。第一是通过修学这个止禅，以便证得这个禅那，以及修学世界分别观，以便证得净行定。第二呢是关于到观这个摄具的指示，也就是要观这个究竟摄法以及究竟明法的指示。第三呢是明摄法的11种观法。第四就是关系到要观过去式以辨证的缘摄受持。这四个主要点呢是在对于那些相信坚信缅甸传统的禅法那些普遍的禅法的人呢所觉得难以接受的，因为呢要难以接受说如何这样观过去的明色法，这个观过去明色法这点呢对于他们来说是难以接受的，所以这是也就是缅甸僧团理事会所要求删除那些句子的主要原因。
So finally, may you be able to practice meditation and attain what is already in this masterpiece.
最后呢，祝福大家愿你们都能够修习这些禅法，而且找到永恒的安宁和寂静。
Thank you very much for Pandey Nyanchala's presentation. 非常感谢智勤长老的发表。我们现在呢有10分钟的时间作为讨论。 Now we have 10 minutes for discussion. 那如果还有其他那个时间不够的话呢，我们可以把今天对针对这两个发表的讨论呢，可以放在下午我们有4点到5点半呢，回应完之后呢，就是一个公开的讨论。所以如果真的时间不够的话，可以留到那个时候。那但是我必须提醒，就是请尽量针对这两位发表者，就是净法长老跟智行长老的内容来提问。OK，please， 那个麦克风，我们格维达长老那个先发问了。
I just wish to make some correction in the paper. This is page number 55. 1.1, first volume, the last passage. We have mentioned 11 kinds of material, or 11 kinds of materialities. So this means present, past, future, and far and near, gross and subtle. And we have 11, but we don't use as 11 kinds, we just use as 11 categories or 11 ways. Okay? So I just want to make that correction.
Okay. 长老做了一点纠正，这是针对第55面那个翻译，那讲到那个缅甸总统的教法观照的11种，这个观照11这个种，那翻译那个英文翻译是11种色法，他说是11个方式去观照色法，而不是11种色法，是11个方式观照色法，是这样子，不是11种色法，请给纠正一下。
Thank you very much. 还有没有其他的 any other questions or comments? 好，请你按着。
想请教那个吉祥凡，那个有关在49页有讲到那个根据两部经和嘎都啦、马杜苏卡跟朱央塔嘎都啦这2部神经。
皮带束缚经，皮带，那个皮带，皮带束缚，被皮带束缚，皮带束缚经。第一个是第一步，第二个是第二步，都是同一个经题，但是呢，有两步，可能像第一、第二这样子吧。
I'd like to ask Bande Dhamma Subho, can you give a suggestion for a beginner how to study the 7 book in sequence?
Actually, as I mentioned, they are not really in order of chronological order because for example, the first book published was Light of Wisdom, but here it's put the fifth. So really, there's no, because these are not, how should I say, subsequent chapter, like this is part one and this is part two. They're not like that, it's because they are independent of each other. So really there's no fixed method to understand Seado's way of teaching. So maybe we can say, you can start off with the earlier publication, like Knowing and Seeing and Light of Wisdom. Then later on, he goes into more specific introduction to the practice, like the only way for the realization of Nibbana. And mindfulness of breathing, where several points out Anapanasati Sutta specifically. Whereas knowing and seeing and light of wisdom is very general. So maybe we can start with the general readings first, and then into specific readings like this Satisutthana Sutta, which is the first one, and mindfulness of breathing Sutta. So there's no fixed order to as to which one we can start off.
首先讲的是这个不是这个这里的排列呢，它不是根据它的出版的那个零排列的。那比如说第一本书是智慧之光，但是呢它是第一本最初出版的是智慧之光，但是呢在这里是排到第五，所以他们这些这每一本书籍呢，他们之间呢是独立的，是并不是说照顺序这样子，所以也没有一个固定的方法说应当怎么样。那但是呢，也许可以这么做，就是你可以先从比较普遍性的书籍，就是如实自见和智慧之光开始读，然后呢，过后再读更特别的，就是更专的一个课题，比如说也是第一本书关系到这个思念处的，然后那是更专的课题了。所以基本上呢，或者过后呢再看这个更专的，讲到这个安波念，那是更专的。所以其实我们呢可以先从比较基础的这个智慧之光，或者是这个如实之见开始读，然后再读入这个更专的，像这关到四念处的这个正悟涅槃的唯一道路和这个安不念，那是比较专的。
好，请继续把握时间。
那我想要请教一下吉祥尊者，就是你这边提到帕劳禅师他就是说去修行他这个过去的这个名色法，那我们在观照的时候，就是我们在去看这个过去容易，其实还蛮容易被就是那个观照那种被束缚，那为什么帕劳禅师要特别去提到要用这个观照过去的这个名色法作为他的一个修行
束缚？
就是你看的时候，其实就是会不会陷在那个状态，就是我不太。
其实他在禅修者在观过去的那个目标的时候，其实在体会上，在真的观的时候呢，也好像那个观的状态是当下的心在观的，所以也没有那个束缚的那个情况。当他们有足够的定力的时候，他可以观过去的目标，然后呢，但是呢，那个心是一样的，是当下的心在观的。
那我想要请问，那就是帕劳禅师特别提到要去看过去的原因是？
主要是要了解那个缘起，缘起，因为如果没有观过去，缘起是牵涉到像无明缘行这两个部分，无明跟行，这是过去的。如果没有看过去的因，那他就不会了知这个缘起的真相，所以没有了解缘起的真相是不能够证悟的。
This is she was asking why Paul Chatterjee emphasized so much on the seeing the aggregates of the inner path. So actually the reason the Chatterjee emphasized on the seeing the path, five aggregates, is actually to in order for us to understand the penetrate dependent origination, because as we know,Avijja, Bajja, Sankara, this Avijja and Sankara really refer to the past past five aggregates, past already past phenomena. But without understanding this, we will not be able to penetrate independent origination. So the theology's explanation emphasize is just to teach according to the Buddha's teaching so that the disciples can understand dependent origination. And without understanding dependent origination, this is not possible for anyone to penetrate the Dharma, for the Buddha's truth and get enlightened.
Have you any other suggestions or questions? Any comments or questions? Would Professor Lang's cousin like to make any? 好，有两个举手。好，那希望问题可以稍微简短一点，后面先好，那再。
就是既然是帕尔禅法，它是会因为有关过去跟未来，这样就可以了，那会被禁止。那其他的禅法都没有关过去跟未来这个缘起呢？我想也有很多禅法有关缘起，那为何帕尔禅是它的关过去的缘起这边会被禁止呢？
要请教这个
都可以，谢谢。
其实并不是说八和禅是讲到观过去的这个缘起，观过去是不禁止，只是因为禅师说观过去这个是需要的，是必须的。那么那其他的禅法，因为他们在缘起的时候呢，并没有如佛陀讲解缘起一样涵盖三世的那个层面，所以因为并没有禁止说这个观三世的缘起法是有错，而是说禅师说这个要观三世是需要的。那么因为讲到它是必须的，那其他的就变成感觉上受批判了。所以他们的也没有说禁止禅师的这个教法，只是说怕引起其他的禅修法呢的恐慌。She was asking whether why the Bao Xiaotuo's teaching about seeing the practicing dependent origination by penetrating and analyzing the past aggregates, and why is this prohibited? Actually, I corrected the questions because the thing is not that Bao Xiaotuo's teaching about seeing past five aggregates.That is prohibited. The method is not prohibited. What was suggested to remove from Xiaotuo's books was basically because Xiaotuo's mentioned about the necessity of penetrating five past aggregates, and this is necessary. Because of that, it caused some worries in.It may cause some worries in those who practice meditation without teaching about practicing dependent origination based on past, present, and future. So it is not the method that is a problem, that is a cause of concern, but rather it is this it may affect the statement of Xiaotuo that it is a necessity to practice dependent origination based on past, present, and future. It is such a statement that it is necessity that may cause worries in other practitioners. So that is the reason Xiaotuo's writing was suggested to be removed, that sentence, that it is necessity.
Would you like to offer any comments? 好，那最后一个问题。
就是文章里面有提到说禅师的教法跟缅甸传统的禅修方式是相违背的，但是又没有违背巴利圣典，那请问传统的禅修方式是什么，然后它有违背巴利圣典吗？
禅师一向来在处理这个课题的时候只讲到自己佛陀的原始的教法是怎么教的，然后呢他当时是佛陀的根据佛陀的经文是怎么讲的，然后呢至于其他的从其他方面呢我就没有去进一步的去讲了。 原因是我们团的包禅是一直来秉持着这样的一个原则，就是我们只讲解这个佛陀的原始的教法是怎么教的，然后让听众他们自己去理解到底然后尝试自己去看到底佛陀的教法是怎么教，然后呢，然后至于牵涉到别的禅法，然后我们还是保留不去评论的。So question is saying that since Sayadaw's teaching about the meditation, about the Buddha's meditation guidance was actually in accordance with Pali Canon, but there are other teaching which are, and yet this method, this original meditation teachings is there are differences between this teaching and other meditation teaching. So does it mean that other meditation teaching is also against the Pali Canon? We don't say that we keep to Sayadaw's approach and that we always teach, Sayadaw always says that what is the original way taught by the Buddha, but without venturing to discuss about other meditation method. So it is up to the audience to understand how the Buddha's teaching, how it originally appears to us. Then how the other meditation method stands in the context of Pali Canon that is not within our effort, to our duty to explain. So we will reserve on this point.所以这是关系到呢是否其他的禅法在这个巴利圣殿里是如何的其一种处境，这个涵盖量涵盖面太广了，我们在这方面保留，那我们只能够说我们讲解的是这个根据我们所了解的巴利圣殿的这个禅法是怎么样的，如此而已。所以请允许我们呢保留这个课题。
好，非常感谢，我们这一场次呢就到这里，如果还有相关的问题一定要问的话就可以留到下午。 Okay, we would like now to close this session. Thank you the presenters and all the audience. 谢谢，感谢大家的参与，那我们待会那个休息20分钟，10:50的时候呢再开始，10:50再回到这里开始，谢谢。